All right, Devin Haney said he threw you out of camp because you weren't pushing him in sparring. Tell us your side of the sparring.
Dice que Devin Haney estaba hablando por ahí de que te botó de gimnasio porque tú no lo estabas empujando suficientemente a él y de que tú no eras suficiente para hacer el entrenamiento con él. ¿Qué tú crees de eso? ¿Cuál es tu historia?
Bueno, no sé qué carajo está hablando este tipo. Este tipo no rompe ni un huevo. No tiene, sí. Tiene pegada.
I don't know what the fuck this guy is talking about. That guy can't even break an egg, man.
Okay, so what do you think of a fight between you and Devin Haney?
Dice, ¿y qué tú crees de una pelea entre tú y Devin Haney?
Bueno, que haga que sea posible que se comunique con Mike Haymon y Luis de Cuba y uno. Pues, él no sé de realmente qué carajo está hablando Devin Haney porque la niña mía pega más duro que él.
Dice, he can contact Al Haymon and Luis de Cuba Jr. and let's make the fight. But, you know, the other thing I want to add, I don't know, really, I don't know what the fuck this guy is talking about because my daughter hits harder than he does.
Here we are with Fighter of the Year candidate Hector Luis Garcia. Now we're going to address the Devin Haney issue. And what we're going to get at is real simple. You can fool some of the people some of the time, but you can't fool all of the people all of the time. There's three ways you're going to get kicked out of a camp. Either one, you terrible. Two, you're a bad influence on the guy. You partying with the guy, taking him out. He speaks Spanish, the other guy speaks English. Or three, you just didn't want that sparring for whatever reason. Now, I've been in camps with Sugar Shane Mosley. I've been in camps with James Toney. I've been in camps with Robert Guerrero. I've been in camps with Alexander Lara. I've been in camps with Joel Castamore. I've been in camps with Chico Corrales. My cousin fought in the 1956 Olympics, Louis Molina. So I've been around this game just for a little bit. Now I'm gonna let the people decide. We got an undefeated Olympian, world champion, and they said he wasn't enough to push him, so they got rid of him after 2 days of sparring, because he wasn't enough of a push for him. But I never got a call back. I got all the lefties here. I got Alberto Cuello, world champion. We could have went with him if he needed a guy to push him who was a little bit size bigger. We got Eric Rosa, another world champion we got here, could have pushed him. We got Carlos Adamas if he needed a bigger guy. I got Arislander Lara that I work with if he needed a bigger guy. I got David Rao that he could have asked for sparring. Did he need a push from them kind of guys? I got Olympian Lanier Perot. Did he need a push from him? Undefeated top 10 heavyweight. Maybe that's the type of push he needed this far. I don't know. Maybe he needed his brother, another Olympian that we had. I don't know what kind of push he was talking about. But that being said, you know, who did he bring in for sparring for JoJo Diaz? Was it Errol Spence? I don't know. But we'll leave it at that. We'll let the people make up their mind.
I'm Ellie Seckback. Ellie Seckback reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.